Hare Krishna. The wild mind will make us homeless at home. Our mind is extremely strong and it can go from one corner of the world to another in one moment. In fact, one part of the universe to another in one moment. And it's not just that the physical distance our thoughts can cover, but it's also the emotional distance. If we have certain biases, prejudices within us, preconceptions, misconceptions, then somebody might be physically close to us, but we will be very far away from them. The restlessness of the mind can also impel us to such actions that distance us from others and distance them from us. So basically, Krishna cautions us that normally what we consider as a shelter, our own home, now that home can be wrecked by our mind. Because the mind is like a deadly storm. It is like a deadly wind. Stormy wind, actually. Krishna says in 6:34 in the Bhagavad-Gita, Arjuna who says that, Chanchalam himanha Krishna pramathi balavadradham tasyaham nigraham manye vayorivasudushkaram. So chanchalam, the mind is restless, but pramathi, it's also mad. It's not restless like a child, it's mad like a psychotic person. And imagine if it's not a pramathi balavadradham, it's also like a person is psychotic and is bodybuilder. And on top of that, that person is also headstrong, super stubborn. And there is very little, the big danger from that person. And Krishna gives the comparison like a stormy wind. So, if we listen to our mind, it can carry us far away from everything that we value. It can make us homeless at home. We can feel lonely, we can feel alienated, we can feel disconnected, can feel suspicious, and we basically condemn ourselves to even when life is comfortable, in our home is comfortable. So sometimes when we are having strained relationships with people, rather than blaming people, we need to check whether it is our mind which is making us averse to them, and that's how we are getting into trouble because of that. So if once we understand this, then we can take steps forward and move in our life in a way that is progressive. And if we focus on not just building our physical home and making it comfortable, but also restraining the mind so that we are at home, so that we are emotionally available for connecting with the people at home. For we are available at the level of the mind to avail of the comforts of home, the facilities of home, then actually we will be at home. And then we actually feel the joy of being at home. And the ultimate home for the mind is the lotus feet of Krishna. When we are fixed in his lotus feet, then we can be always purified, always uplifted, always elevated. And bhajahure mana shrinandanandana abhaya charanaravindare. When we fix the mind in Krishna, then we feel peaceful, we feel joyful. So thus, rather than listening to the mind and going wherever it wants us to go, we listen to Krishna and get the mind to Krishna. And that's how we can be home, both physically in terms of being as comfortable as possible in this world and being at home spiritually, being connected with our eternal all-attractive Lord. Thank you. Hare Krishna.